let's talk about how to get Google's version of Talkback onto your Samsung device and why or why you shouldn't do it. Hi everyone, this is Carrie on Accessibility and I talk about technology and accessibility. When it comes to Android, you have a lot of devices to choose from. I personally am using a Samsung S22 Ultra and I use Talkback and magnification as well as other accessibility features with it. There are some pros and cons when you consider accessibility on Samsung devices. Samsung has their own version of Talkback. The Samsung version of Talkback, even though it's a higher number in the Galaxy store, is behind by a couple months in comparison to Google's Talkback, which is in the Play Store. This is because every time Google releases a new version of Talkback, Samsung takes it and makes their own modifications and makes their own changes and optimizations for their devices. Sometimes Samsung's version of Talkback can be slightly faster and might be better optimized for Samsung apps and things. When you get a Samsung device, it comes with the Samsung Talkback, and there's no easy way of downloading the Google version of Talkback and taking off the Samsung version of Talkback. It's really a shame that it takes Samsung such a long time to push out updates for Talkback, and it can be really frustrating, especially when there are really good new features coming to Talkback, but Samsung users won't be able to use them because of a delay. A really big example is Talkback Actions. If you're on Gmail and your focus is on a specific email, you can swipe up and double tap on delete. There are a lot of places where actions are really useful, and as apps get updated, they are also implementing Talkback Actions. This is something that VoiceOver has had for a really long time, and it's about time that Talkback has it, and it's just a shame that there's a lot of people that aren't able to use it. There were other updates like better braille display support and spell check and a lot of other things that Samsung users will just have to wait for Samsung to get their game together and update Talkback in the Galaxy store. And by that time, Google is probably going to push out a new version of Talkback. The good news is you can actually install Google's version of Talkback onto your Samsung device. And my friends from Blind Android Users, which is a really great podcast, go and listen to them and subscribe onto their YouTube channel and all the, those other platforms as well. They came out with a really great video and guide of how to install Google's version of Talkback onto the Samsung. John Dyer did the demonstration and the explanation, and he did a really great job. Go watch their video, and all the files you'll need will be in a Google Drive folder, which is linked in the description. I really held off on actually installing the Google version of Talkback onto my Samsung device because I wanted a true-to-life experience when I create videos and content, because I know most people that have a Samsung device will be using the Samsung Talkback. But after a lot of prompting and reminding, a friend of mine on Discord, which you guys should totally join, it's a really awesome place and it's the best Discord server out there, I finally did it and now I have both. I just really love having Google's version of Talkback on my phone, and I also have it so I can use the Google version of Talkback most of the time, and if I need to, I can pull out the Samsung Talkback. There are some drawbacks to installing Google's version of Talkback on your Samsung device though. First, there are more bugs that are not on the Samsung's version of Talkback. And if you provide feedback on bugs like this that only happen with Google's version of Talkback on a Samsung phone, Google can't support that. They won't help you, they won't support it, they won't really fix it because, you know, of the whole Samsung Talkback issue, which I'm just gonna say it right here and now, Samsung and Google need to work together on Talkback. Instead of increasing the fragmentation of Android, they just need to stop. They really just need to stop and just have one version of Talkback. And if Google and Samsung really want to work together, they can work together on making Talkback better. But they need to actually work together instead of having separate versions of Talkback, because this is absolutely absurd. And honestly, this is part of the reason why Android gets a bad rep. All of this having to jump through hoops and having to make choices like this is just absolutely terrible and is a bad user experience. I think part of it is Samsung wants to have some level of control. And no, they just need to stop. They need to let go and work together more closely. It's really frustrating. Okay, I'm done. Rant is over. Anyway, if you want to have access to both the Google version of Talkback and the Samsung version of Talkback, you can follow the steps in John's video, and that will uninstall Samsung's version and install Google's version. And then you want to make sure to change the accessibility shortcut for the Google version of Talkback. Then after that, you can go to the Galaxy store, look for Talkback and install it, and make sure they always have different accessibility shortcuts. Another warning I can give you, which I found out, is you want to make sure you turn off one version of Talkback before turning on the other version of Talkback. Otherwise, it's really hard to turn both of them off because they kind of suspend each other, and then you're just left in this endless loop of Talkback going back and forth between the different versions, and then you can't turn it off, and then you have to restart your phone, and so if you're using Google's version of Talkback, turn that off and then turn on the Samsung one. And then if you want to switch back, turn off the Samsung Talkback and before you turn on the Google's version of Talkback. I have Google's Talkback set to the volume up and side key and the Samsung Talkback set to the volume keys. Talkback on. Home. Digi-clock. So I just turned on Samsung's Talkback and now I'm going to turn on Google's Talkback. Talkback off. Talkback on. Now I switched over to Google's Talkback, which has a red focus indicator. If you keep switching back and forth like this, it won't actually turn Talkback off until you remember which one to turn off first, so it's really confusing. That's why I really recommend, if you want to have both on your phone, make sure you turn one off before you turn on the other. That's pretty much it for this video. Let me know down in the comments, if you're using a Samsung device, do you use Google's version of Talkback or Samsung's version of Talkback? I really just don't know why they can't work together, or at least make it so that we can easily install both. Okay, oops, I said that I was done. So that's it for now. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell for more videos on technology and accessibility. Thanks everybody, and I'll catch you in the next one.